Hello everyone, this is Dr. S. A. Mohan Krishna, Associate Professor in the Department of Mechanical Engineering of Vidyavardhaka College of Engineering, Mysore, Karnataka. In my previous lecture videos, I could cover the information concerning with internal combustion engines. The complete theoretical description followed by numerical problems pertaining to that were comprehensively discussed. But in the coming lecture videos, I'll be covering the information pertaining to refrigeration and air conditioning. In the course Elements of Mechanical Engineering, as you are aware of the information, particularly in Module 3, internal combustion engines followed by refrigeration and air conditioning have to be discussed. Earlier, internal combustion engines have been covered, but now I will be taking with refrigeration and air conditioning. Before that, we shall peep to the course learning objectives. We know that we are discussing internal combustion engines and refrigeration and air conditioning. Course learning objective is very clear: to understand the concepts pertaining to IC engines and refrigeration. Now, coming to the presentation, directly going to the subject, refrigeration will not be useful to anyone. Initially, we shall discuss the introductory aspects, the historical perspective. Even though it is not important in the examination point of view, from the curiosity corner, it is very important. In the beginning videos, I'll be covering refrigeration, and later I'll be concentrating on air conditioning. You may be wondering, where is the need for learning refrigeration and air conditioning? We would have separately learned refrigeration or air conditioning. What is the privilege in learning both? Refrigeration and air conditioning are like couple. Both are dependents. One is totally dependent on the other. They are like husband and wife. They are meant for artificial cooling. Refrigeration and air conditioning will be extensively used for achieving or accomplishing artificial cooling. How is this possible? What are all the technical content we should see? That we shall discuss in this lecture video. The first and the foremost, what exactly is this refrigeration? When was the idea of refrigeration conceived? Who are all the pioneers responsible for the development of refrigeration? What are all the components in a typical refrigeration system? Classification, then theoretical description, all contents shall be covered comprehensively. The first and the foremost question: who invented refrigeration? What is the idea of this refrigeration? The answer is simple. Your grandmother invented refrigeration. By listening to this, majority will be discombobulated. The state of confusion will arise. What is this? Grandmother invented refrigeration. What is the idea? You can just remember the prehistoric era or epoch. You may remember the grannies using earthen pots to preserve milk-related food articles. They were using earthen pots. The concept of earthen pots is nothing but to achieve the mode or the means of artificial cooling. Since then, people were aware of cooling process, but thermodynamically they may not be aware of the information. But when exactly the accurate ideas came into picture, came into existence? So after 1740s, 1750s, many of the pioneers were responsible in the significant growth of refrigeration, artificial cooling. Some of the pioneers responsible for the development of refrigeration systems are, to begin with, Sir William Collins, next Benjamin Franklin, John Barber, then Oliver Evans, Sir Jacob Perkins, Sir John Gore, Alexander Twining, James Harrison, William Siemens, Carl von Linde, and many more. If I start listing out the names of the pioneers starting from 1750 till date, I have to name at least 50 to 60 pioneers. But the persons responsible for developing the exact or the accurate forms of refrigeration are Sir Oliver Evans. He is regarded as the modern refrigeration father, or father of modern refrigeration system. Sir Jacob Perkins and James Harrison are responsible for inventing refrigeration system. In 1834, the first ever person who led for the invention of refrigeration or refrigerator is Sir Jacob Perkins in 1834. Later in 1852, Sir James Harrison modified whatever it was developed, and he could develop the other form of refrigeration. When we come to the broad classification, it will be clearly focused. Having historical perspective or background in mind, now we can peep to the technical information pertaining to refrigeration. For a common person or a layman, how one can clearly convince the definition of refrigeration, or what is a refrigerator? Nowadays, in majority of the locations, in most of the houses, we find a refrigerator. So a person without having the basic idea of refrigerator, I think it is impossible. We find advanced forms, versions of refrigerators. But without knowing the actual meaning of refrigeration, we are seeing to that. For a layman, how can we define refrigerator? Refrigeration is the art of maintaining the temperature below that of surroundings. You know, we have surrounding temperature. Within the refrigeration system, the temperature will be normally cool or it will be very low. That's why when we take up the definition in a very professional way, the process of reducing the temperature of a system below that of surroundings and maintaining this lower temperature within the boundary of a given space is called refrigeration. This is the very professional way of structuring the definition of refrigeration. The machine or device employed to produce refrigeration effect is called refrigeration machine or refrigerator. In the colloquial context, we all know that refrigerator is called a fridge or frigidaire, the device which has the potential to achieve freezing in the idiomatic context. But the professional way of giving a correct name for the cooling system is refrigerator or refrigeration system. In addition to that, when we take up the other mode of achieving artificial cooling, that is air conditioning. As said clearly in the beginning, refrigeration and air conditioning, they are the systems which have the potential to achieve artificial cooling. So the principle of refrigeration is that the heat is to be removed continuously from a system at a lower temperature and transfer it to the surroundings at a higher temperature. Please remember this principle. Without knowing the principle of operation, we will not be in a position to dive to the depth of the content. Bearing this thermodynamic information in mind, let me take a simple example or a reference. You can experiment this at home. When the door of the refrigerator is kept open for few minutes, normally what sort of experience you feel? The obvious answer will be, it will be obviously cool. It is evident that it will be cool. You said that the temperature inside a refrigeration system will be obviously cool when compared to the surrounding temperature. If that is the case, when we keep the door of the refrigerator for a few minutes, naturally it will be cooler experience. Friends, it is incorrect. You please see to this aspect, the heat is to be removed continuously from a system at a lower temperature and transfer it to the surroundings at a higher temperature. So what will happen? Whatever heat extracted within the refrigerator, it will happen at lower temperature, and the same when it is dissipated to the surroundings, it will happen at higher temperature. That is why we will not experience any sort of cooler situation, it will be warmer. This is purely depending on second law of thermodynamics. So when we learn a course, engineering thermodynamics, he or she will be in a position to know the depth of this. Kindly remember, at this point of time, invariably the principle of operation of a refrigeration system or a heat pump or a heat engine depends on the relevance or the application of second law of thermodynamics. Bearing this information in mind, we should know the information in depth. Initially, we should have the theoretical idea of refrigeration system. Later on, what are all the technical terms associated with refrigeration? So these content, let me cover in this lecture video so that an individual will be in a position to get the introduction or prelude in a very elaborate manner. Before knowing the technical terms employed in refrigeration, we should be aware of the components in a refrigeration system. Anyhow, in the coming lecture videos, I will be taking that in detail, but before being well acclimatized with the terms used in refrigeration, we should know the exact nuance of refrigeration. What is the inner meaning of that? How exactly artificial cooling can be accomplished? Please remember, in a human body, we have a variety of organs. To begin with, mouth, throat, next, larynx, pharynx, stomach, small intestine, large intestine, many organs we find. Very analogously, in the case of a refrigeration system, we have many components, but four are very, very important. In order to work in a very effectual manner or effective manner for a refrigeration system, we need to name four pillars in that. Who are the four pillars responsible for achieving smooth functioning of refrigerator or a refrigeration system? They are mainly evaporator, compressor, condenser, and expansion device. Initially, I will give the information in a very concise manner. When we come to the principal classification of refrigeration system, I will take up in detail. Which is the first component we need to take up in a refrigeration system? It should be evaporator. You can clearly understand evaporator is a device that has the potential to achieve the process of evaporation. During evaporation, heat is supplied or heat is added. So whatever fluid or refrigerant we consider initially, it will be in the liquid phase. What exactly is this refrigerant? Refrigerant is a thermofluid medium that circulates in a refrigeration system. That is the fluidal medium present that has the potential to extract heat within the refrigeration system. So from evaporator, liquid refrigerant shall be converted into vapor refrigerant because of compression. In a compressor, which is the second component in a refrigeration system, compressor compresses the refrigerant, wherein liquid form will be converted into vapor form. After compression, high pressure vapor refrigerant shall be developed. From compressor, it moves to condenser. The condenser is the component wherein artificial cooling process takes place. During evaporation, heat is added. In a condenser or during condensation, as said just now, it achieves artificial cooling process wherein heat is rejected. Eventually, the refrigerant comes to expander. In an expansion device or a throttle valve, the least possible temperature is achieved. So these four thermodynamic processes will be responsible for achieving the process of refrigeration. This has to be clearly accentuated in the beginning so that one can be easily familiarized with the technical terms used in refrigeration. Now, one by one, let me take up the technical terms. The first and the foremost is refrigerating effect, which is abbreviated as RE, and the notation shall be Q. It is the amount of heat extracted within the refrigeration system. In thermodynamics, when we learn the module 1 in elements of mechanical engineering, formation of steam, the amount of heat generated in a thermodynamic system, it shall be referred to as enthalpy H. Very similarly, the refrigerant which has the potential to extract heat within the refrigeration system, it is refrigerating effect. It is expressed in kilojoule per second or watt. In a very professional way, the rate at which it is removed from the system in one cycle of operation. This is what refrigerating effect is. Next, the very important, widely discussed term, when we need to know the capacity of a refrigeration system. For a layman, when you talk to a vendor in a refrigeration shop, he will tell in a colloquial context, the capacity of the refrigerator is 220 liters, 265 liters. But thermodynamically speaking, which is the unit that you can take up to understand the refrigeration capacity? It is called ton of refrigeration or TOR. Well, how exactly or what exactly is this ton of refrigeration? As just said, ton of refrigeration, TOR, is a unit of refrigeration capacity. One TOR indicates the amount of heat that needs to be extracted from 1 ton of water at 0 degree centigrade to convert into 1 ton of ice. 1 ton of ice meaning 1000 kg at 0 degree centigrade in 1 day or 24 hours. In a very simple way, how we can understand ton of refrigeration? It is the amount of heat required to produce 1 ton or 1000 kg of ice When the initial temperature of water can be 0 degree centigrade for the duration 1 day. That is why when we calculate 1 ton of refrigeration, it is equivalent to 3.5 kilowatts or 210 kilojoule per minute or 14,000 kilojoule per hour. How normally or how usually we get this unit? Very simple. 1 ton meaning 1000 kg. 1000 kg, if we wish to produce, we require 1 day. 1 day, 24 hours. In 1 hour, we have 3600 seconds. In addition to this, we have something called latent heat of fusion of ice. The thermodynamic value is 335 kilojoules per kg. To produce 1 kg of ice, the magnitude of latent heat is 335 kilojoules. So, how can we calculate this? 1000 into 335 divided by 24 into 3600. If we do that calculation, we get the value between 3.5 to 3.87 kilowatts. If in a numerical problem, we wish to calculate power or some other determinant, 1 ton of refrigeration is equivalent to 3.5 kilowatts. We will not be taking any numerical problems in elements of mechanical engineering concerning with refrigeration and air conditioning. But in a course engineering thermodynamics, the students of mechanical engineering will learn in applied thermodynamics. In that, they learn in depth. But here, we should be aware of the theoretical aspects very meticulously. The next term associated is ice making capacity. For a layman, how we can explain that? Ice making machine is normally specified by its ice making capacity. It is defined as the capacity of the refrigeration system or potential of the refrigeration system to make ice beginning from water. This is the basic information what we should be aware of. You all know that how ice is formed mainly depending on the quantity of water used. Ultimately, how we can get back the original content of water when ice melts, we can regain the original condition. So this is in a very simple way ice making capacity. Next, along with the use of ton of refrigeration to express or to indicate refrigeration capacity, we have yet another very salient term, coefficient of performance. Coefficient of performance, for a layman, how we can explain? You all know that while learning internal combustion engines, I emphasize the term thermal efficiency. Normally, efficiency is the ratio of output to input. But what input, what output, that is the question we need to answer. When we take up thermal efficiency, it is work done by the engine to heat supply during combustion. But here, when we wish to calculate coefficient of performance or performance assessment of a refrigerator, how we can take up? It is very simple. It is the ratio of heat extracted by the refrigerant within the refrigeration system to work done by the refrigerator. Mathematically, eta thermal for any heat engine is W by Q. But in case of refrigeration, coefficient of performance, the mathematical interpretation should be Q divided by W. That's why thermal efficiency of any heat engine you take up practically, it can never touch 100%. As discussed in the case of diesel engines and petrol engines, the thermal efficiency, practically speaking, it will range from 35 to 40%. But under theoretical condition, it will be much more higher. But coefficient of performance, when we consider in the context of refrigeration, definitely it can exceed 1. 1.7, 4.3, 3.6, the value of coefficient of performance can definitely vary. So, in any interview or in any test, technical test, you should be clearly aware of the difference or the distinction between thermal efficiency and coefficient of performance. So, coefficient of performance is the ratio of heat extracted within the refrigeration system to work done by the refrigerator. One more aspect I need to clearly emphasize at this moment. While explaining the theory of heat engines, internal combustion engines, earlier in one of my lecture videos, how we could calculate work done by the engine, it is very simple. It is heat added minus heat rejected. Heat addition takes place at higher temperature, heat rejection takes place at lower temperature. But here, it is exactly the opposite. Work done by an ideal refrigeration system is the difference between heat rejected and heat added. Heat rejection takes place at higher temperature and heat added at lower temperature. Immediately a question will pounce on me or it will pierce me. What is that? How exactly in the case of refrigeration work done is heat rejected minus heat added? I said while explaining the principle of operation of a refrigeration system, during condensation heat rejects. Heat rejection will take place at higher temperature. Evaporator, heat addition. Heat addition takes place during evaporation, but it takes place at lower temperature. So, in a simpler way, how can we structure the sentence? Heat rejection at higher temperature will be more than heat addition at lower temperature. That means to say, condenser temperature will be invariably higher than evaporator temperature. First comes compressor temperature, next condenser temperature, next evaporator temperature, finally the temperature during expansion. Kindly remember the simple principle of operation of a refrigeration system. Evaporator, compressor, condenser and expansion device. Next, we should be aware of yet another term called relative coefficient of performance. Relative, you can understand, you have relatives, closer relative, distant relative. How we can establish relation in the context of coefficient of performance? It is the ratio of actual coefficient of performance to theoretical coefficient of performance. Always remember, theoretical value will be more than actual value. Theoretical meaning based on the calculation. Actual meaning the practical. So as everyone is aware of the information, always theoretical value dominates the practical value. That's why if you wish to structure the definition for relative coefficient of performance, it is actual coefficient of performance to theoretical coefficient of performance. So these were the information I was willing to convey in this lecture video. But for 5 minutes, if we just glance the information, I think you will get the overall summarization. Let me take up the summary for 5 minutes. Let me summarize all information. If you wish to know the exact definition of refrigeration, please dig the historical perspective. I could inform the names of the pioneers, propounders, promulgators responsible for the development of refrigeration system, starting from William Cullen, Benjamin Franklin till 1950-1970, there were many pioneers responsible for the significant growth of refrigeration system. So refrigeration is not new to us. Yet another information what I wish to connect in this point is, or in this moment, there is a very fascinating subject which is really resourceful for the researchers, that is cryogenics or cryogenic engineering. The content cryogenic engineering is highly favorable depending on the principles of refrigeration. Seeing to the technological advances in refrigeration system, now many researchers are exploring on cryogenic engineering. Even cryogenic engineering began after 1840. So when we know the technical depth of refrigeration, understanding cryogenic engineering will be easy. So that's why academicians, scientists, researchers, then the students or researchers who are pursuing PhD, they are all highly supporting cryogenic engineering. Earlier it was said that refrigeration and air conditioning both are important. They are the means meant for artificial cooling process. So artificial cooling process is mainly happening due to the processes encumbered in refrigeration and air conditioning. Next, some of the technical terms that were clearly explained are, number one, refrigerating effect. Very simple way, the amount of heat extracted by a refrigerant within a refrigeration system. Next, turnoff refrigeration. It clearly emphasizes refrigeration capacity. So 1 ton, what is that? It was clearly taught. Next, what exactly the meaning of ice making capacity? Next, what is the inner meaning of coefficient of performance? You should be clearly aware of the distinction between thermal efficiency and coefficient of performance. Thermal efficiency can never exceed 100%, but coefficient of performance can be within one or above one. The reason is very obvious, it is heat extracted to work done by the refrigeration. The last term what we could learn is actual coefficient of performance. So to know more about refrigeration, so these were all the aspects what initially one has to be familiarized. Comprehensive introduction to refrigeration. The next one, the technical terms employed in refrigeration. So in the next lecture video, I'll be concentrating on the types of refrigerants. What are all the very prominently used refrigerants? What is the classification of refrigeration system? Academically speaking, which are all very important, that we can discuss. Friends, I wish everyone to know the technical content in detail so that the depth of refrigeration could be clearly understood. With this, I wish to conclude this lecture video. Thank you very much.